Deepfake. After we play and tunes.
But if I lay down and I play dead and I stay dead, maybe you'll get sick of being the monster out of my head under my bed.
Hello, welcome to Rifki the Cyber. We already see the deepware.ai before, right guys? Now what I'm going to show to you is, what about if we make our own Python script for the deepfake detection or deepfake detector? This is the good news. And the good news again, this is not using the GPU. What I'm going to say to you is, this is not really a commercial ready. You need to pre-train again the model that I'm going to give it to you. And I'm going to share also what is the GitHub that you can do if you want to test this one, guys. So rather than a lot of chatty, let's test, guys. So this is the GitHub. Actually, this is my GitHub in this case. Deepfake detector. You just need to go to the code and then download the zip, extract the zip, and then later you can find it like this, guys. Right? This is, for example, is like this. I think when you try to run it in the very first time, you might get some error. For example, oh, this module is not yet exist, or this module is not yet installed. So I suggest this to you. For example, I will just make some... I will go to the document, for example. I will go to documents and I will make some directory again. Test, for example. I will just make test. Now, I suggest this to you. I need you to create the isolate instead you install it the module one by one, which is will affecting your core Python that provided by the system originally from your MacBook or from your own Windows, for example. I want you to make the environment to isolate this one, then install by one specific for this project, so it won't affecting your own OEM Python that bring by system installations in this case. So how we can do it? We just need to do like this. Python 3 is Python.3.8 in this case, and then minus M in this case, and then we just create fenf, right? Fenf in this case, and I will just make deepfake environment in this case. So I'm going to do like this, boom, and it will create my own environment in this case, guys. Okay, after you create your own, for example, environment in this case, so what you need to do is, you just need to activate that one, source, and then deepfake environment bin activate. Then you already in the environment itself, guys. So it is good for you to start the script itself. So what am I gonna do? I'm going to run this script. Now you will get some error, no module name with numpy. But since you already in the deepfake environment, it will give you the peace of mind to install it one by one, for example, guys. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to install this. I'm going to install this pip3.8 install numpy. Whoops. Like this, okay? So it will collecting and install numpy inside of this deepfake environment in this case. So you just need to do it one by one until this is finished, right, guys? So until all the module is already okay, then you are good to go to running the script after this. And for example, if you want to go out from this, you just need to run the activate. So you will go out from this environment in this case. But guys, I already installed it one by once, but you know how to do it. I already show it to you. So rather than a lot of chatty, let's test again directly using the Python script that I'm going to show it to you. So the script will be running like this, guys. Python 3, for example, in this case. And the script itself is in the... let me check one more thing. Did I show it to you this one or not? Okay. I think already show it to you this one. This is the tree. The script is here, and there is a model also here. This is for the face recognitions, and this is the our object to detect later, guys. So for example, right now let's do the scripting here, guys. Python 3, and then scripts, and then the script name frame by frame, and then after that, I'm going to check this video, for example. This is the data video, for instance, in this example. And then also the model to detect the deepfake itself. And then also, the model to get the deploy prototypes for the face recognitions in this case. And then I decided to choose true to save the JPEG or the frame that we suspect this is, there's a deep fake in this case. So I'm going to run this one, guys. Okay. Aha, look at this. Authentic. This one is really written here, for example. Ah, okay, this is authentic in this case, right, guys? It seems this means the confidence level of this script is saying, I'm not confident to say this is a deep fake in this case. So what we're gonna do, we just going to play with this, the score of the confidence level in this case. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to play with this one. Let's check, for example, the script itself. I will just make the fine tune of the score, for example, if more than 001, it say that this is the deep fake. Let's test again, guys. Ah, here, deep fake. After we play and tunes with the score of the confidence level in this case. Or we can play, for example, you want to decide, let's say we are using the 002, for example, in this case. Deepfake, sometimes they admit this is authentic. Sometimes they say this is a deepfake, for example. This frame they killed authentic. This is deepfake. Almost seems like a deepware in this case, guys. But the thing that I'm going to tell you is this, guys. This is the artificial intelligence, guys. You may play with this score, but this score is not something like instant like that, because the one who take the very important role is actually the exceptions model, the H5 itself, the one that is in this argument, the one that I'm going to show you. This one, let me check with this three, this one, guys, for example, the exceptions in this case. So this is really taking the important role. And if you want to get this, you need to pre-train, to pre-process the image. And after from the image, you need to do some training. And then you will, from the training itself, you will get the result of the training, the model, which is in the form of the format of the file, which is this one. Bottom line, guys, everything related with the artificial intelligence is the non-trivial problem, guys. This is the thing that you need to remember of this one. Okay, guys, I think my video is sufficient. This is not really ready for the commercials. You can play later for your own environment. For example, if you have a GPU, it's much better. You can using the library of CUDA. And as I always say in my other previous video, keep learning and stay humble.